tell you about some features of the plant which is on the cover of Annals of Botany this year. It's Leucospermum, a genus in the family Proteaceae. This is a largely southern hemisphere family, which is in Africa and in Australasia. Over the last 4 years, the background image on our cover has come from four different continents. In 2012, it was the Bedens daisy from Ethiopia in Africa. The previous year, it was a tree from the Cerrado vegetation in Brazil. And before that, we had banana growing in South China, and we had a rose from England in Europe. This meant it was a turn of Australia to provide the cover image. The family Proteaceae is one of the iconic taxa of Australia, with genera including several species of Banksia, the type genus Protea, and the nut Macadamia. In fact, I first came across the genus featured on the cover, Leucospermum, growing in Australia, in the garden of Professor John Pate, a regular contributor to Annals of Botany, with many papers on roots and plant nutrition, soil-water relations, and featuring aspects of the Australian native flora. Actually, Leucospermum is from southern Africa rather than native to Australia. The criteria for the cover are not only being a very high resolution picture, but also having the ability to cut out the plant from its background so that it can be imposed underneath the title and the picture which changes for each month. Fortunately, this rather rules out one of the best known of the Australian genera, Banksia. Banksia has the beautiful bottle brush flowers, but they are very complex and wouldn't fit well. I also considered using the rather spectacular cone of Banksia, which could be cut out, but I felt that overall the brown and green colours of that wouldn't stand out enough and set off the other parts of the cover. So what about other genera in the family Proteaceae? I mentioned that Leucospermum is native to South Africa, but growing in Australia, but I've already done a video blog about another Proteaceae species which is native to Australia, but is grown in Africa. And that video blog was about the use of Grevillea for erosion control and soil restoration within northern Ethiopia. And the link is there for you to see that particular video. In Annals of Botany, we have quite a lot of papers about the domestication of wild species and what happens to them when they're introduced into agriculture. Interestingly, despite the large area and varied climate across Australia and New Zealand, there's no major species which have been introduced into food production. However, perhaps the most significant of all of those is actually one of the family members from Proteaceae, and that is the macadamia nut. These are an interesting fruit, and it's notable that among all plant products which aren't processed, it has one of the highest fat contents at more than 75%. There is another Australian plant which is important worldwide, not for food, but as a fibre crop, and that is eucalyptus. It was, of course, used extensively as a hardwood timber in Australia and provided the timbers for railways and for houses. It also, in the 19th and early 20th century, provided the wood blocks that were used to pave the streets. Now, we're very reliant on eucalyptus as both a source of construction timber, but extensive plantations of it for fibre production for paper. So I hope that the last few minutes have given you some insights into the diversity in the plant family Proteaceae from the Southern Hemisphere, and given some insight into the different genera within it, whether those are the ornamentals like the Leucospermums, the important groups of the Banksias, or the one crop from Australia, the macadamia nuts.